welcome to anyone who was dragged along by their friends, having been assured it wouldn't be that folky. And we're going to try and get you to sing a chorus. This is a song about Hallows Eve. And it's really easy, Principal. I'm going to sing the opening line, and with Phil and Miranda, you're going to sing it back in glorious harmony. All right? People are looking worried. Go light the lantern at your door.
Go light the lantern at your door.
And honor those who've gone before. Come on.
And honor those who've gone before.
The worlds that part us now are twain.
The worlds that part us now are twain.
And Hallows Eve is here. The westering sun grows pale and wan, the day grows dark, the nights draw in, the autumn leaves are tipped with fire, fruit hangs ripe upon the briar. Now our twain, for Hallows Eve is here again. Sweep out the hearth and clear the grate. Bid for the welcome at your gate. Gather the final harvest in, for all the hardship winter brings. Season turns to frost and dew before the sun its strength renews.
Go light the lantern,
it's here.
And honor those who've gone before.
The worlds that part us now are twain,
for Hallows Eve is here again. Go light the lantern at your door. And honor those who've gone before.
The worlds that part us now are twain,
for Hallows Eve is here again.
Well sung. Miranda sold out of marmalade. Josh is desperately asking her if she's got any more pots. That's what's going on. Miranda has assured him that there aren't any more. See, the Josh is now inconsolable and he's gone down to the beach.
Well, the rest of the crew have already made their toast, you see, and all they're waiting for is Miranda. But you lot have bought it all.
Look, I owe you all an apology. I'm sorry. There will be marmalade next year. I promise.
But it's got something when the crew will actually come on stage to implore her. We're going to sing a song from Centenary called The Keeper, overlapped with two folk songs as well. So this is a record we made last year featuring the voices of Jim Carter and Imelda Staunton. And it has to be said that my status in my household as a folkie is not particularly high. But when I could get the guy who plays the butler in Downton Abbey on the phone, I had maximum respect from my wife. If only I could get the guy that plays pole dark to phone me up, then I could walk on water.
And his cakey tea.
You can go down my mine, Ross. None of the men are laughing, Phil. This is a keeper. One, two.
In Devonshire, I was a keeper. Half my life, I lived outdoors. Using skills my father taught me on the land that edged the open moors. I'd cut the snares of every poacher, rising hours before the sun. I set traps, I planted cover.
Released about four singles, sent them up to Radio 2 to be appraised, and the consistent response has been that they are very well produced songs but contain too many issues for the daytime listener. This was the last of our offerings but one. This is called Roots, and it was written originally just as a reflection that the English don't have many songs we can sing together in pubs. Phil and I can remember this from when we used to do pubs in this area. And one thing that playing in pubs does do, it cures you of the desperately sad singer-songwriter syndrome. You know, you don't go down the self-pitying route when you're playing in Gosport. I remember one particular night, I started a new song. I said, I don't know why Sarah left me. Well, I do, mate. Kindly replied a guy playing darts. So anyway, that's what the song was all about. Really. It wasn't a call to invade Poland or anything like that. Just about the need to have more songs. So we're going to just slow it down. This is Roots Light, as it were.
Now it's been 25 years or more. I've roamed the land from shore to shore. From Tyne to Tamar, Severn to Thames. Moor to Vale, Peak to Fen. Played in cafe and pub and bar. Stood in the streets with my old guitar. But I'd be richer than all the rest. I wish I had a pound for each request. For Julian Banjo's American Pie. It's enough to make you cry. Rule Britannia, swing low. Are they the only songs the English know? Seed, bud, flower, fruit. We're never gonna grow without their roots. Branch, stem. When the cake's been cut, the disco's over and the bar's shut. Birthday, christening, wedding or wake, what can we sing till the morning breaks? For the Indian, Asian, Afro count, it's in the blood below the belt. Singing and dancing all night long. What I ain't got a right that we've got wrong. In a pub near Wells, well, I've got a vision of urban sprawl. Pubs where no one ever sings at all, and everyone stares at a great big screen. Overpaid soccer stars, prancing teens, Australian socks, American rap, mystery English baseball caps. And we learn to be ashamed before we walk.
This is, I suppose, quite a Paul Darkian story called Cruel River. It's the first of at least two Dartmoor songs we're going to play tonight. Someone got overcome then. What happened? Did something go down the wrong way? Oh no, what am I saying? I won't say that again. Rich farmer, beautiful farmer's daughter and farming lad, and they fall in love. Not the farmer and the, you know. And then the River Dart plays a part in their story. This is called Cruel River.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed.
I've got a happy birthday that I'd like to wish to my next door neighbour who's here today, Louise, wherever you are. A friend of yours came up, hello. Everybody would like to wish you a very happy birthday, so there you go. Happy birthday.
Also Ethan, who's 13, I believe, yesterday. He's over there. He looks a lot older than that. Oh, there he is, Dan. Oh, he's asleep. And Jan, you were... I'm not going to say how old you were, but... happy birthday, Jan. We played Are We All Right For You earlier, OK? So wherever you are out there. I know the present came late, but, you know, you can't blame me for that. But still. So when we were playing back in the pubs and stuff, there's a couple of good rhythms that used to go down quite well. Here's one of them. I quite like that one. Better than that one about his girlfriend, Sarah. I couldn't stand that bloody thing, but... This is the latest Go Down Well in a Pub offering, we need a bit of help on the percussion. Please welcome Jack Knightley out. Come on, Jack. Yay. Jack, who was at Glastonbury last week with me, and his first experience of a major concert is to see Motorhead in full blast. So I think he's been safely rewired now, and get all this folk nonsense out of his jeans, and... see Lemmy, yes. So, and Lemmy is going to join us for she moved through the fair in about 10 minutes. One, two, three. Clap. He never says, Steve Knightley on good bit of song and impression. aggressive hair tossing or anything like that. Kids just get taken from this place. We're going to sing a song called The Lads in Their Hundreds, which is a poem by A.E. Houseman put to music, originally by George Butterworth, but this is not Butterworth's version. This is more like an English Morris tune. Butterworth was a... Guys, can you keep it down just a bit? Butterworth was a fine poet, a fine composer, and he put Houseman's words to music. So this is from Centenary. Again... If anybody wants the Morris dance, no, perhaps they best not. Lads in the hundred. Oh, we haven't done the raffle yet, have we? That's what you're, that's why nobody's left. Okay. The lads in their hundreds. The lads for the girls and the lads for the liquor are there.
For many, many years, we've been doing this song. It comes from the writing of a bloke called Sidney Carter, who may be familiar to some of you as both a leading Quaker, but perhaps more importantly, as one of the founding fathers of the CND movement. And he wrote a song called Lord of the Dance, which is still sung in schools to this day. But he wrote lots and lots of other songs, including this one, Crown the Cradle. I think it's much better. But I've been looking after my elderly pop recently. It's been one of those years. And you think you know everything about your parents, and in fact, I've discovered I know nothing. Because for some reason, he got talking about when he was in the army. And sort of towards the end of the Second World War, he was a young lieutenant, and he was shipped off to Ireland, of all places, not to Germany, because there had to be a military presence in Ireland, even at the end of the Second World War. And he said, oh, yes, yes, yes. I remember now, I used to share a room with another lieutenant, and it was Monsignor Bruce Kent, who was actually the founder of CND. I've never, my dad's 88, and I've never known that until this very, very day. But I'm going to dedicate this song specifically to my dad, and I hope he's listening somewhere along the line.
Sheep's in the meadow, the cow's in the corn. Now is the time for a child to be born. He'll laugh at the moon, and he'll cry for the sun. And if it's a boy, he can carry a gun. Baby's a girl, never you mind
we are in reflective mood. We'll play a song that Phil and I first played about 20 years ago in Bedminster in West Dorset. And we played again at the school a couple of nights ago. It's called The Blue Cockade. And it was a folk song that was collected in Bedminster in about 1906. And most versions we knew when we were young were sort of very raucous and up-tempo, almost like a marching song. But this is slowed down. A guy walking over the hills meets up with a party of soldiers and he has to tell his true love that he's agreed to go away for a year. It was on. It wasn't on. It was on a Monday's morning as I crossed over the moors. I little thought of listening till the soldiers did me cross. The company enticed me to drink their health around, and the bounty, and the bounty. remembering how well Kilgerry Mountain and anything by the Pogues used to go down well, I wrote this song called The Galway Farmer, and it seems entirely appropriate. Hasn't won yet. We'll see.
Actually, we're going to do the abbreviated version, if that's all right. I didn't go to Cheltenham that year, thank you.
And the next song we're going to do, give us an E for.
An E!
Got to get in character for this one.
Hello there.
Yeah, I might well get even more in character. I shall summon up the ghost of my Northern Ireland grandmother. I work my days on a Galway farm in the sun and rain, wind and storm. But once a year I'll chance my arm and cross the sea to England. I'll scrimp and save £2,000 to spend the week in Cheltenham town. But the racing over always down, I'd come back poor from England. I dream one night before I left a coal black mare with a white star chest. Crossed the line and beat the rest. I came back a rich to Galway. Rose at dawn, drove all day, thinking, wondering all the way. Lady luck, if you come to stay or steal away my morning. And when I got to Cheltenham town, Irish faces all around. No bed, no mattress to be found. I slept on the hillside. Spent 3 days at the viewing green and saw the horses they led in. Just when I was giving in, I stood and stared in wonder. With stamping hooves and steaming breath, a coal black mare with a white star chest. I ran my finger down the list, that's the name and number. Lady Luck had come halfway, the horse's name was Galway Bay. 20-1 the odds that day, I went to make my wager. I counted out £2,000, held it high, slapped it down. The bookie smiled, he made no sound, but I knew what he was thinking. I was the biggest loser in the land, with a pounding heart, shaking hand. I made my way up to the stand, and the horses came to order. And I cursed my farmer's luck to hell. But the second and third she took quite well. The way behind the leaders. And then moving sweetly from the back, she found the rails and caught the pack. 10 to go from the track, hooves were drumming thunder.
Flashing in the sun, 8 to go and a mile to run. Two are up before her on the straight down this way. Left one at the last for dead. Bought the next and by her head. She came home the winner. Oh, winner! Must be written by A.P. McCoy. So I came back to my Galway farm, a wiser and a richer man. Never again to chance my arm across the sea to England. Cause Lady Luck wasn't mine that day. I held her close and I went my way. Will you raise a glass to Galway Bay and the dreams of a Galway farmer? We should draw the raffle now before it gets too dark for you to see your ticket, so... Don't forget, there's two prizes. One prize is a weekend ticket to Village Pump, and the other is a fine tenor guitar. But I'm not feeling particularly good at the moment. Let's make the first draw the Village Pump ticket, Phil. Put your hand in my bucket.
On the yellow, 2, 5, 6. 2, 5, 6.
Go and see that man in the white hat, Mr. John Oldeslade.
Next to the other man in the white hat.
Yeah. Do you think they're a couple for that? And the next prize is for the fine Nick Noddy tenor guitar. Miranda.
And the winner is on the pink, 406. 406 on the pink. Peach.
Orange.
Orange.
Marmalade colour.
Anybody?
I can sing a rainbows.
Got it.
Congratulations.
Go. Fantastic.
You're not having my one, you've got to go and get one off him. It's backstage, okay? Backstage. It's backstage and, yeah. It's amazing the way a raffle adds energy to the set. Motorhead didn't do a raffle, Jack. I said that without moving your lips.
Lay me down,
gently down.
Song from Dartmoor. There's a bit of a story for you. As many of you may have known, I've just done a tour of 140 village halls all over the country. I've been traipsing, and my theme next year is called All at Sea. I'm looking for little venues that are next to the tide, next to the ocean, which came as a bit of a bad news for a lady called Daphne out there who lives in Widdicombe on the Moor. She's been trying to book me for a village hall gig for about 3 years. And she came up earlier after I played in South Brent, said, will you please come and play Widdicombe next year? And I said, I can't, I'm playing maritime venues. So I got home that night to find a message on Facebook saying that, from Daphne, saying, I've just formed the Widdicombe in the Moor Sailing Club. And in due course, a membership card came through the post. So now you actually, there is a Widdicombe in the Moor Sailing Club that's putting on shows up in Widdicombe in the morning. And I said, and she said, will you now come and play? I said, how could I refuse? So my only non-maritime show next spring will be Widdicombe in the Moor. So check that one out. I think it's a great idea.
So there's a huge, huge legacy of piracy in Widdicombe anyway. Sheep stealing and all that kind of thing. Yes.
See? Yes.
And there they are, Phil.
Absolutely.
So that little boy that got taken earlier, he's off to Widdicombe.
Yes, yeah, that's just
terrible, isn't it?
I know, it's terrible.
Cousin Jack!
Follow me down. Our tongue is no longer
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Do you know what happened once? We're playing at Cambridge Folk Festival in a couple of weeks. And about 5 years ago, knowing that the TV like crowd reaction shots, we got. I said, why don't these like girls get on your bloke's shoulders and everybody stand up, put your hands in the air. And so blokes got on girls' shoulders and girls got on blokes' shoulders. It was a fantastic piece of footage. And they used it as an applause reaction shot for another band on the TV. I mean, how unfair is that? Somebody wasn't going down so well, and we didn't even get on, did we, Phil?
No.
But we're not bitter or twisted.
No, certainly not.
I wrote a song called AIG a few years ago, thinking this won't have a shelf life for very long, will it? Because now that the economy is in such perfect condition and everybody is prosperous again, it's hard to think, could there possibly be another corrupt, venal, parasitical, cynical bunch? And yes, along come FIFA. Hands up who's going to Qatar to see the World Cup. Yeah, no. So I'll dedicate this one to a wonderful man, a kind and honest elderly man, a father figure to a wonderful sport, the beautiful game. I'll dedicate this to Sepp Blatter. It's called Arrogance, Ignorance and Greed. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Day, we might all be free.
Sound and Josh on lights and everything, production manager. Please give the crew a round of applause. Feeding us back there as ever with Steve and Terry and Claire and Nick and Richard and Mary Claude. So thank you again, everybody, for looking after the musicians backstage. You didn't get fed by them, but we did. And Nick and John Aldersley for the amazing raffle prizes. A round of applause for them. Vaughan and Gwen Pierce have been running Abbotsbury for the last years and years and years. This year, Vicky and Amanda have been at the helm, so give all of them a round of applause, please. Thank you very much. Thank you, Vicky. Thank you, Amanda. Have I missed anybody out? No, there was a guy who made me a really good couple. No, that's about it. No, thank you very much. We are on the road. We're playing all the festivals, and then we're out again. Come and see the big autumn tour. We've got a wonderful support act, us three. We'll finish with this song, and we need a bit of help, I think. Come on, Jack. This is called Aunt Maria.
Call me Aunt Maria.
One more time.
Aunt
raised over £1,000 for the Bramble Ward Fund and the RD&E in Exeter. Thank you so much. That's going to make such a difference to people that might be in the position that my family was in 5 years ago. So thank you, everybody. Thanks, Nick. Thank you, John. Thanks, Abbotsbury. One of the best ever, by far. Thank you so much.